Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Did you know it's a great day to wear a watch? In case if you're new here, my name's Dave. May the Schwartz be with you. Today, I'm super stoked to share with you a full, complete, and detailed review of the Bulova Chronograph C watch that I recently picked up. Now, before we do that, let's do a quick wristwatch check. So this is my other watch from Bulova, the Precisionist, which you can check out the full review up here. It's a really impressive dress watch. Now I have to take a quick second and do a shout out for my fellow YouTuber, Average Joe Watch Reviews. You can check his channel out up here. He recently had received a watch from Traveling Watch Project, and I'll link their Instagram down in the description for you. It's a very unique looking dial, and I'm super excited to see the full video that he'll be releasing, where he'll share about the story of this project, how it came about, the Veterans Watchmaker Initiative grant, as well as how people can participate. So if you have not subscribed to his channel, get on over there, show him some love from the Schwartz Force. All right, let's get started. All right, look at this beauty right here. The Bulova Chronograph C watch, model number 96K101, is a reissue of a vintage watch that came out in 1970. Originally nicknamed the Stars and Stripes due to its use of red, white, and blue, as you can see on this striking dial. It was only produced for 1 year, so these are a bit rare and hard to come by. If you do find one, be prepared to spend anywhere from $2,500 up to $5,000, possibly even more. Yeah, the vintage version features a Valjoux 7736 manual wind movement. The Chronograph C was a bit different from other watches in the 70s due to a few features. First, it was absolutely massive at 43 millimeters compared to so many other watches that were often under 37 millimeters and rarely even close to 40 millimeters, let alone 43. Second, instead of deciding between choosing a metal bracelet or a leather strap when you bought this watch, you actually got both, which is a cool feature. While not as iconic as the reissue of the Bulova Moon Watch, we are getting the same high performance 262 kilohertz quartz movement. And we'll get into that a bit more later. Now I gotta say this retro design is very cool and funky looking, and I think I may like it more than the Moonwatch right now. And when this thing first launched, it had a retail price of $750, but I was able to get an absolute steal on eBay where I picked this up for $135. Now that price did come with some disadvantages, as it did not have the original box, the additional blue leather strap, or the special spring bar tool that would have come with a newly boxed watch. And I thought hard about it and decided to buy it anyway, as I don't do much with all the watch boxes I do get. I can easily get a nice leather strap aftermarket, and I already have most of the tools that I would need in regard to watch repairs and upgrades. And you can pick up a new version with all the goodies on Amazon for about $260. So let's get some measurements. Now, case diameter is 46 millimeters, but don't let that scare you off yet. Now, if you haven't noticed, this is a lugless designed watch, so it wears smaller than you would think. Now, if we include the crown, it does come to a measurement of 50 millimeters. Case thickness with this dome sapphire crystal is 14 millimeters. The bracelet is 20 millimeters wide at the case and does not taper. We get this beautiful Milanese designed mesh bracelet in stainless steel. And I have to point out that not only is it very comfortable, but does not pull any arm hair, which is much appreciated. I really like how they included the Milanese look also onto the front of the solid links. It gives a nice look of continuity from the bracelet. This watch comes with an insane amount of links, so I don't think you'll have any worry about sizing it if you have a larger wrist. A bit disappointing, however, is this stamped folded clasp. And my assumption is that Bulova wanted to stay true to the vintage design, but I personally would have liked to see a milled and more substantial clasp. Aside from that though, this clasp has double locking pushers on each side and gives 4 micro adjustment slots. Now, I like the vintage Bulova branding that we see here on the clasp as well. Moving to the case, we see here on the side that we get a full stainless steel case and case back with brushing on the sides and polish on this beveled edge that slopes downward to the case back. The bezel is polished and features a deep coin edge pattern but does not rotate. We see that we have these high polished piston style pushers above and below the crown that feel great when actuating. The coin edge crown protrudes just a bit, which makes for easy time adjustments. I like that they kept that vintage Bulova font on the crown as well. This dial has so much going on and I just absolutely love it. And when I first saw this watch, it reminded me of something you'd see like in an animated cartoon or comic with a pop filter effect. And due to these striking contrasts in the blues and the whites and the reds, it also has this elementary school kind of vibe to me. With the use of the red and blue being primary colors that we first learn about, and the shape of the minute and hour hands that look like how a child would draw a house. A simple rectangle with a triangle on top for the roof. I just love this look for some reason. The dome sapphire crystal gives us a bit of distortion when looking from an angle, and we also see this mirroring effect along the ray hot where a tachymeter is printed. And I love this matte blue color and the vintage Bulova wording at 12 o'clock, it's just the right size. At the 6 o'clock subdial, we get our running second hands, which we can see is using the high performance movement as it ticks at 2 ticks per second. I think it's a pretty cool feature and quite different from the common mecha quartz movements we often see in chronograph watches. When we start the chronograph with the top pusher, you'll see that the main second hand has this very smooth sweep. We get 10th of a second indication at the 3 o'clock subdial. Now this subdial will only run for 30 seconds, but it does keep time, so when you stop it, it'll automatically track it to the right 10th of a second. And this is fine because obviously that's to preserve battery life, so I get it. At the 9 o'clock subdial, we have our chronograph minute counter, which will run for up to 1 hour. A no date feature on this dial keeps a nice clean and symmetrical look. It's done very nicely. Now hidden in this dial are these piston-shaped hour markers that are loomed. It's a really pleasant surprise when you first see them glow after being out in the light for a bit. The loom captures light great and activates them very easily. However, they won't last all night like you'd see with Super Luminova, for example. I think it's okay since this watch only features 50 meters of water resistance anyway, so it's not something that's to be used as a dive watch or field watch in that regard. So let's put it on the wrist as we summarize. So this watch knocks it out of the park for me personally. Checks almost all the boxes for me. Value, as I got a great deal for it. Sapphire crystal, high performance movement, unique design that stays true to the original, and history from a well-respected and known brand, enough water resistance where I don't have to worry about if I get caught out in the rain with it on. Cons for some would be its obvious large size, but I think if you have medium to large wrists, this one will work just fine as you can see it here on my 7-inch wrist. Other cons would be better loom for those who like more potent night vision, perhaps higher water resistance if you wanted to wear this thing around the pool, maybe a flyback movement with the chronograph instead of that long sweep to get back to zero. If you like this review, please be sure to hit that like button down below, share it with any friends, and make sure you subscribe to be a part of the Schwartz Force if you haven't joined the channel yet. And let me know what you think of this one down in the comments. I always look forward to y'all's comments and input, and I enjoy interacting with each of you every time. So thanks again, and as always, may the Schwartz be with you. Take care.